Well, this is a beautiful map of the observable universe. Every dot on that map is a galaxy with 100 billion stars like our sun in it, at least. You see that the structure in there, they're not randomly distributed. It's very interesting. I'm going to show right at the end of the talk that we think we're beginning to understand where that structure came from. Just to get some sense of scale, that little line up there, you might not even be able to see it at the back, but that's the 1 billion light year line. So light takes a billion years to travel from one end of that line to the other. This is the observable universe. And I'm going to show you, there's a ridiculous number that I have to show you. It's better to show it than say it. This is the number of stars that we think are in the observable, well, we know from observation are in the observable universe at the moment. 30,000 million, million, million stars. Just like our sun, some bigger, some smaller. 350 billion large galaxies, 7,000 billion smaller dwarf galaxies. That's the observable bit of the universe. We have pretty strong evidence now the universe is significantly bigger than that, but we can just see this blob surrounding us, the blob from which light has had chance to travel during the history of the universe. So the universe is big, is what I wanted to say to you. I don't know if you know a comedian called Woody Allen. He once said that the universe is probably infinite, which is a bad thing if you're one of those people who can't remember where they put things. But it's enormous. So how can you... Oh, I don't want to start that yet. There we are. So how can we possibly begin to think about explaining that? You know, how do we know, first of all? How do we know it's so big? How did we find that out from this planet that we're standing on now? And how could we begin to make theories, guesses, I suppose, if you like, about where that came from, how it began, how fast light travels, all those facts that I've said to you, or all those numbers that I've given out that are our best estimate of how the universe works. It is, of course, science. And I wanted to just play you a little video of, for me, what the best definition of science or the scientific method that I've heard comes from a very famous physicist called Richard Feynman, who won a Nobel Prize for building one of the first quantum theories of electricity and magnetism. It's called quantum electrodynamics. This is back in the 1940s and 50s. It's our best theory today of how light interacts with matter. But Feynman was also, I recommend that you read his books. He was a brilliant teacher, a brilliant lecturer, as well as a Nobel Prize winning physicist. And he gave this lecture back in, I think it was the 1960s, and it's just a 1 minute definition of the scientific method.
I'm going to discuss how we would look for a new law. In general, we look for a new law by the following process. First, we guess it. Then we... Well, don't laugh, that's the really true. Then we compute the consequences of the guess to see what, if this is right, if this law that we guessed is right, we see what it would imply. And then we compare those computation results to nature. Or we say compare to experiment or experience. Compare it directly with observation to see if it works. If it disagrees with experiment, it's wrong. And that simple statement is the key to science. It doesn't make a difference how beautiful your guess is. It doesn't make a difference how smart you are who made the guess or what his name is. If it disagrees with experiment, it's wrong. That's all there is to it.
Yeah, I think that's a really beautiful description of what science is. It's really very simple. It's the application of common sense in many ways. What it is looking at the universe, looking at nature, guessing about how it works, seeing what the consequences of that guess are, testing those against nature, and as Feynman said, the great power of science. It doesn't matter who you are. There's no such thing as authority in science. If your guess disagrees with nature, then it's wrong, and that's all there is.